God's not through with fire yet. So I proceeded to go on. 10 surgeries later, next thing they tell me I'm not diabetic, they tell me I'm insulin resistant. They put me on medication. Since I've been on the medication, now I've had 65 kidney stones. Now, how many have ever had one kidney stone? Now listen, somebody said it really accurate. Men don't know anything about having babies. And if anybody tells you having a kidney stone is like having a baby, you ought to just whip them right there. Because I had both my kids natural. I'm a strong woman. But a kidney stone takes on a whole new life of its own. First time, every kidney stone, I prayed for death. I would go into the hospital. It was the same thing. And now it's not doctors, it's anesthesiologists, and they tell you, you know, you could die when you go. You don't take care of yourself. You know, you're not having no problems. You can't feel these kidney stones. And I'm thinking, God, how much more do I have to go through? 65 kidney stones later, so many other things attacking my body. And I asked God, where are you? But I found that Paul was trying more than anyone. And it encouraged me when I read 1 Corinthians 11:23. Because it said in labors more abundant. He was in stripes above measure. Yeah. In prisons more frequent. Yeah. In deaths often. Yeah. Of the Jews 5 times received I. 40 stripes, save one. Thrice was I beaten with rods. Once was I stoned. Thrice I was shipwrecked. A night and a day I've been in the deep. In journeys often. In perils in water. In perils of robber. In perils by my own countrymen. In perils by the heathen. In perils by the city. In perils by the wilderness. In perils by the sea. In perils among false brethren. In weariness and painfulness. In watchings often, in hunger and thirst, in fastings often, in cold and weakness, besides those that are without, that which come upon me daily, the care of all the churches. But Paul said, who is weak? Am I not weak? Who is offended? And I burn not. If must needs glory, I will glory in the things which concern my infirmity. But God showed me, Pastor Flory, that there comes a tower in being afflicted. Now, God spoke to me a message about Job. And you know, Pastor, we always say, I know you hear this. I wish God knew my name. I wish God knew my name. I wish God knew who I was. But you know, I think that Job would disagree with you somewhat. Because the second time around, God said, have you considered my servant Job?
Right.
Now, this was my moment. I said, well, what about her? Right. Have you considered her?
Yeah.
Or did him? Pastor.
Yeah.
And there are no wager here. And God said, you know what? I got so much confidence in my children. I'll let you have it the first time around. I'll let you have it. They'll be in your power. Second time around, he says, have you considered him? He's upright. Because see, you're not going through trials because you're a jerk. Despite what your neighbor is telling you, in spite of what all the naysayers are telling you, you're going through hell because you're doing something wrong. Sometimes you're going through hell because you're doing everything right.
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 You know, you and I got the Bible. What did Job had? Oldest book in the Bible. son, I'm not going to just give him into your power. He tells Satan, behold, he's in thine hand, but spare his life. I got a question for the Church of the Living God. What do you do when you're in the hand of the devil, but you're in the will of God? All
right.
That's biblical. That's Bible, people.
Yeah.
He's in thine hand to save his life. And I learned through some sufferings and much prayer that, you know, it's having a hard time, Brother Flurry, because I know who I used to be. Why would God pick me? Why would God anoint me? I was the trash in the class. I was the nobody. I'm having a hard time believing that God loves me that much, that he would allow me to go through hell and yet still believe that I would emerge victorious. So there is a power that comes.
Mom.
After you've been afflicted. 2 Corinthians 12 and 9 said, and he said unto me, my grace is sufficient for me. Yes. Now when you're going through trouble, I hate that scripture.
Right.
Don't you want to whack those people who tell you that? Because they're always the people who never even had a hangnail. I don't even like to sit near those people. They make me break out in hives. Because you know nothing about my
suffering.
My grace is sufficient for thee, for my strength is made perfect in weakness. Now for type A personality, that does not work with me. Because you strive for perfection. You strive to make it. You strive to be on top and not the bottom. You strive to succeed and not fail. To lay down and die to this flesh is hard.
Yes.
But he said, my grace is sufficient.
Right.
My strength will be made perfect in weakness. So he says here something that I never could understand. Most gladly, therefore, will I rather glory in my infirmity. Has he swallowed his tobacco? Only crazy people glory in infirmities. You just got a little too much juice laying down, Jack. I'm in a hard time glorying in the middle of hell. But he said, I'll rather glory in my infirmities than the power of Christ may rest upon me. Therefore, I'll take pleasures in infirmities. I'll take pleasure in reproaches, in necessities, in persecutions, in distresses for Christ's sake. For when I am weak, then am I strong. I don't know who I'm preaching to tonight. The devil's tells you you're in a dead and glorious God. But I tell you, the devil is a liar. You're not beaten. The glory of God is about to rest on you. We've been laying dark for a night, but God's coming.
Praise God.
I heard a powerful statement the other day. One small crack does not mean that you are broken.
Right.
It means that you were put to the test and you didn't fall apart.
Well, yeah.
Just because there's a crack in your life, there's a crack in your faith, it doesn't mean, precious saints, that your faith is broken. It just shows me that you were put to the test and you still have it together.
Yeah.
But if you're not careful, you can become disillusioned in the middle of the storm. What happens, Pastor, when God has so much confidence in me that He allows the billows to roll? Now, it's one thing to go through one thing.